second standard that touched me so much. He said, and when I think that God, his son, not sparing, he never spared his son, Jesus, just for you and I. Amen. He sent him to die. I scarce can take it in. That on the cross, my body gladly bearing, even on that cross, even in that pain, he was still rejoicing just for you and I. He bled and died. Blood gushed out from him just for you and I. What my father cannot do for me, what my loved ones cannot do for me. Why? Just to take away my sin. Appreciate him this morning if you are grateful. Appreciate him. Appreciate him. Appreciate him. Reference his holy name. Give him all the glory for taking away our sin. For sending his only begotten son Jesus to redeem us from all unrighteousness. Thank you, precious Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah, church. A round of applause for Jesus. John chapter 9, 35 to 41. Yes, you are there, Mary. John chapter 9, verse 35. And Jesus heard that them has cast him out. And when he has found him, he said unto him, dost thou believe on the Son of God? 36. He answered and said, whom is he, Lord, that I might believe on him? 37. And Jesus said unto him, thou hast both seen him, and it is him that talking with thee.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
38. And he said, Lord, I believe. And he worshipped him. 39. And Jesus said, for judgment I am come into this world, that they which see not might see.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And that they which see might be made blind. Excuse me, I'm coming again. And that they which see might be made blind. 40. And some of the Pharisees which were with him hear this word, and said unto him, are we blind also? 41. Jesus said unto them, if ye were blind, ye should have no sin. But now ye say, we see, therefore your sin remaineth. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's bow our heads for prayer. Father, your word has been coming since morning. Father Lord, we pray that your word that is about to come now, eat fruit in our life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Give us a heart of meekness to accept your word. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father Lord, I stand here as a servant. Who am I to be a servant unto a great king such as you are? Lord, use me as a vessel unto honor in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May I not speak of myself, that at the end of this meeting, O Lord, we all shall go home rejoicing in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, precious Father, for in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Hallelujah. Last week, I started a message that titled what?
Understand the kingdom purpose.
God bless you, sir. Understanding the kingdom purpose. And while we are discussing, I introduced the last, the number six, the characteristics of understanding the kingdom purposes. I introduced one, the last one, that is called what?
Inability to see.
Wow. God bless you all. Inability to see. This morning, I will be talking to us on a message I titled, Once Blind, But Now I Can See.
Hallelujah.
If you are clapping for Jesus, you will do better. Once blind, But now, I can see. I was once dead, but now I'm alive.
Amen.
I was once a sinner, but now I am a righteous child of God. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It takes a man who have understood that he or she have missed his road. Someone that is on a journey. It takes him or her to accept, oh, I have missed my road, before he or she can ask questions. Hello?
Hi.
There are some times when we are going to somewhere, we will be roaming around, thinking that we are on the right track. Until you come to your senses, I have missed my way. That is only when you can ask questions. And if you still believe in yourself, that I know where I'm going, even when somebody tries to call your attention, you won't give him that attention. Until you yourself make a conclusion, decide in your heart that I have missed my way. That is whereby when you call somebody to ask for a question, you will pay more attention. Praise the Lord. If we do not accept that we are blind, we can't receive healing. If you don't accept that you have weakness, God will not make his strength made in you. It takes a man who accepts his fault to be corrected. Any man that doesn't accept his or her fault, no matter the English you use, no matter the language, no matter how you explain, it will find it difficult to take correction. But once a man accepts his fault, he will be quickly to get understanding when correction comes in. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And all this cannot function if there is no faith. In everything a man does, faith is very, very important. T.B. Joshua teach one message. There's one of his message that he teach. That do we know that everything takes, it takes faith for a man to do everything.
Yes.
To take a step and walk, it takes faith. It's because I believe that I can move. To take a man to even eat food, believing that I can open mouth, I can put this food, it takes faith. It takes faith for a man to even go to the toilet. That when he was explaining this, you know, and after all, he now said we should thank God for everything. Praise Master Jesus.
Yeah.
To even sit down, it takes faith. You believe that you can sit. And there are people that cannot sit. Praise Master Jesus. Hebrews 11:6 told us that without faith, it is impossible to please God. And he that cometh to him must
believe in him.
Is a must believe. In other words, accept. There should be acceptance. If you come to God without accepting him first, if you come to God without belief, it will yield fruit. So he that cometh to God, he that cometh to the house of God, must first believe that he is, he is alive, that his existence is real. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
John 3:16 said, for God so loved
the world
that he gave us his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth, whosoever, it's an open check, anyone that believes in him shall have everlasting life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, let me come back or come down a little. In John chapter 9, where we read, okay,
yes,
please try and follow me. In John chapter 9, where we read from verse 1, the Bible said that there was a man born
blind.
Then Jesus come and encounter with the man and ask a question. Whose sin is it, the parents of this guy or this guy, that he was born blind? The same way you and I was born into this sinful world, is not by the sin of your father, neither your own sin.
Oh.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It was because of the first Adam. That is where we all sin. But there is good news. When Jesus have an encounter with this man, he said the reason is that the Son of Man might make manifest that in his life, Jesus will perform his work. Do why he was sent to this earth. Now, Jesus healed the man. Give him salvation. In the process of time, the reality why that incident take place start manifesting. A man did not sin, neither his father, but he was born blind. Condemnation. Blindness is death. Blindness is inability to do whatsoever you want to do. Blindness can be sickness, anything that resists you. Anything that resists you for doing what you're supposed to do. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, a man was born blind. He cannot see. It wasn't his sin. But because he was born into this world, and that this work of the Son of Man might made manifest in his life. Now, this man that was born blind, it take him, if you read through that verses, you will see that his belief is quite different. Different from others. Those that know the laws, the professors, those that even teach, the teachers, the Pharisees and the Sadducees. He takes this man that know, oh, I am blind. When he sees, he's confident, his word, everything about him changed. It comes to a time that he will start teaching those who say that they are masters.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Why? Because he takes him acceptance.
Yes.
I am blind.
Yes.
Where we read, he said, who is this Son of Man that I might believe? Why others have been outstanding that? We know Moses. Moses, we know that God speak to Moses. We are the disciples of Moses.
Yes.
But this man never cared. I have seen the light. Jesus was sent to this earth to redeem you and I.
Amen.
We are in the season of, they call it Easter.
Yes.
Some of us, some Christians say the calendar is wrong. Some say it's correct. But the most important thing, we are celebrating the death and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. Now, if through that, we all go into sober reflection, seeing how this man was sent to this earth, how he was killed just to redeem us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But God so loved us that he doesn't want any of us to die, to perish. That was why he sent his only begotten son. But it takes someone who believes in him. Someone who has accept. That is my major key point. Acceptance. You must first of all accept that you are blind. Remember that here, it caused confusion. To the extent they still ask him, do you mean say we also are blind? But he said to them, if you are blind, it would have been better. Because that's why I'm here. If you are a sinner, it could have been better. If you accept that you are a sinner,
yes,
it could have been better. So that my point. purpose can be made manifest in your life. If you accept that you are a sinner, it could have been better so that my death won't be in vain.
Hallelujah.
But even in this world, even in the house of God, some of us, the Bible said, our deacon used it 2 Sundays ago or something. They are serving God. Paul said, I bear them witness that they are serving God, but not according to knowledge. How many times have we asked ourselves questions? The way I'm doing things, is it according to knowledge? Am I doing the right? To you, you might be thinking that, you know, it takes someone for God to remove the veil from your eye before you realize that you are doing the wrong thing.
Yes.
There are people who are doing wrong thing. If you ask them, they don't believe, they don't see it that they are doing the wrong thing.
No.
They do it with boldness, with confidence.
Yes.
But it should come to a time that we as believers should caution ourselves, ask ourselves questions. Am I really doing the right thing? That I'm preaching, that I am communicating, that I'm teaching, I am an elder, doesn't make me, it's not a ticket that I am doing the right thing.
No.
That name does not work if I didn't work.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That you are a choir, an usher, or whosoever, a Christian, a child of God, whatsoever name or title, that name doesn't work until you work.
Yes.
Now, it takes you to say, no, am I doing the right thing? Even as I'm standing on the pulpit, as I'm teaching, as I'm doing this, I'm singing, am I on the right track? You know, there are some people that will tell you, and every time that they see faults, they bring problem.
Yes.
They always they say, now me, they bring problem. Have you really checked yourself? Because if you go deeper, I think you really have that atom in you. Hello?
Hi.
There are people that always say that. I know they find trouble, but they say I always find trouble. Since you know they find trouble, how then do they say you always find trouble? That means something is wrong somewhere that needs to be checked. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If we accept that I make mistake, even in the choir, if you accept that you make mistake, it will be easy for your master to correct you. And it will be easy for you also to accept the correction. When the man met Jesus, he accepted Jesus. When he received his healing, he has never accepted Jesus. But he received his healing. You can speak abracadabra. Still in darkness. Hello? I'm quoting scripture for us. He received his sight from verse 1 in the early stage, but not yet believed, not yet certified. He never received certificate already. He was still preaching the ministry because he started preaching to the Pharisees and the Sadducees, telling them that no man can do this kind of miracle except he's been born again. We have not seen such in Israel, neither it has been recorded on earth, except that this man is from God. They say, who born you? You want to teach us? You want to teach? You know when I started to go to church? Do you know who I am? I am the bomb inside church. My father is a pastor. My father is an elder. My mother is a deaconess. My papa and a father of church. Okay, Ben. Now we get this church. You want to teach me what I know? What do you know? Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It happens here. The man that had an encounter with Jesus was telling them, this thing is not normal. No man can do this. They say, nah, Jesus is a sinner. If really he's a servant of God, why will he go and walk on the Sabbath day? Why will he walk on the Sabbath day? But Jesus said, I will do the work of my Father when there is light. That when night comes, no man can walk. In other words, whenever you have opportunity to do good,
do it.
At every given time, do it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Who do you say heal you? The man come home, he puts feet. If now this day, Jesus, I put feet now for now, pa. Miss it. And say, medical doctor. I am careful not to follow those online things, like as our deacon was teaching this morning. Online things, if you see a lot of things online, so if you are not careful, you're going to sing inside as well.
Yeah, it's true.
People castigate men of God, but Jesus himself put spit on the ground. His spit, oh, not the man's own. Because now when I was okay, put your own, maybe not say something, then my own. Jesus put spit, he missed it and said, the man, go and wash. The man went and he received his sight. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Am I making sense?
Yes, sir.
The question here we should ask ourselves, do you believe in the Son of God? And what does it take to believe in Christ? Because the man asked the same thing. After he have received his sight, after he have preached the gospel to people. The man is an evangelist, so he preached. He even challenged the Pharisees and the Sadducees to the extent they cast him out of the synagogue. It was even casting him out of the synagogue that he now met and have an encounter with Jesus. What an interesting chapter. At your own leisure time, take time, read it. Not let them tire you. Read it. God will give you revelation. Read it again. You get another revelation. Keep reading it. Praise the Lord. It was after they cast him out. Remember, Jesus healed him and go his way. The man took go his way, have an encounter and start preaching the gospel. But he has not believed, never been born again. Now, when they cast him out from the synagogue, because he's speaking the truth. You are speaking the truth, they will fight you. But whether they accept it or not, truth must be said. The man stand, I see his boldness. Someone who knows that I was once blind, but now I'm no longer ignorant of these things. Things have changed. Is this man that used to? He said, yes, I am the one that used to beg. I'm the one that used to. The one you used to know. I am that sinner you used to know. I am that brother you used to know. But today, it doesn't work that way. Hallelujah. I told a sister in Nigeria, one of my friends, I said it in last week, Friday prayer meeting. The girl was a friend of mine. She's married now. Then she has started having some issues, which when our elder declared that 1 week fasting, I told her, join us in this fasting. She did. When on Friday, when I was giving the testimony she gave me, they arrested, her husband used their trailer to carry contraband. They arrested the man and seized the car and begged the man with 1 million. Praise the Lord. Since then, the man has been roaming around and the family has been like this and like this. I have done the little one I feel do. I don't borrow money to start business for. I forfeit the money. Okay, no worry. Forget about it. Praise the Lord. But because the time I told her, even if I borrow you million, there are some things that have to go. If you didn't break some certain things, this million will still go. And I said, join us in this fasting. She did. And I gave a testimony on Friday that she had been, the motor they see, they have called the man to come and carry it. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. Celebrate Jesus, a testimony. Now, I told her, we are going to go into another step. But you see this step, don't look at me as the Jeffrey you used to know before. Okay, because if you look at me like that, you won't follow me in this direction and you won't get the fullness of it. Me that you used to know before, don't. If you look at me that way, it's a lie. I say, if we want to play, we'll play as brother and sister. But you see in this area, see me different. Then I told her, how much do they pay you your salary? She said 7,000 naira in a month. How come? He said, because if they go to do only that, they go to help somebody. He's working for somebody that do only that, go to collect money for people, sure. How can they pay a married man with 2 children or 3, 7,000 naira in 31 days? I said, okay, it's okay. We are going to do something. You see that money, because she called me and said she wanted to stop this month. I said, no, don't stop yet. Finish this month. You see this money, we're going to use and do something. If I say, you give me that money now, it won't have effect in me. Why? Because it's like carrying cup, go fresh water, put for inside sea. I started thinking, what can we do with this money? Okay, don't worry, give me time. I will tell you, but I want you to use this money in another form. She said, please, brother Onuwa, because that's the local name, Onuwa, Onuwa. The local name they used to know me. Brother Onuwa, I be the thing, sir, I want to go, there is one orphanage in our area. I be don't think, but fear not let me. You know when you have such, even if you have that kind of revelation, and God talk to you, you not go accept, sir. I want to go, I be the thing, sir, I will cook, go do this, go do that, but as you talk, and I come, and I say yes, that was why I was trying to search myself. Now, since you also have the revelation before, walk in line with it. Praise the Lord. And see God in action. Now, why am I saying this? People saw the man as a blind man before. They were even contemplating, he still did it, man. He still the man that we used to know. And he was the one that said, yes, so I am the one. You know me before. And today not be the same thing again.
No.
The story have changed. Praise the Lord. Amen. Who is you when I want listening to you? Ordinary Sunday school teacher. Yes. Hello? It doesn't work that way. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? He is somebody. He is the son of the living God. We shouldn't despise anyone. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, like as I said before, that those areas from verse 1 was a shadow of what happened. Now, the reality started from 35 where we read. He got believed and he got saved. Jesus said, if you were blind, it would have been better. But now you say you see. That means your sins still remain with you. In other words, they refuse to allow Jesus to walk on them. You understand?
Yes.
They are seeing physical.
Yes.
But to Jesus, they are blind. And he said, I come because of judgment. Not to destroy, but for those who are sick to be healed. Those who are dead because of sin should be made righteous. But some are still holding to where they are holding. Jesus now said to them, but I'm still there blind. And your sin remains with you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Our Lord Jesus was sent to this earth to redeem us from all unrighteousness. Have you given him the space in your life that I go to church is not that way? That I sit in the front of church is not that way. I pay my tithe. It's me that collect the tithe, or is it that pray for the tithe? Whether God accept, do you know? Hello? Yes, so you know, there are sometimes we ask questions. Why will a prostitute bring their money in the church and pastor collect it? Have we seen such a thing?
Yes.
Why will somebody that sell business or do this come and put tight and pastor collect? Now pastor collect, now go collect them. Hello? Pastor can collect it. But do you know if God, who accept is God? You can do whatever you know how to do best. But does God interested in those things? Saul do the same thing.
Yes.
They said, go. Jesus, God said, go. Do this, do that. Do this, do that. Saul came. This one looked beautiful. I will use it. Let me do this business. If I strike, I'll pay my tithe. Let me do this. If I finish, I don't give God the own. I will renovate this church. In fact, I will put this church upside down and give the church. I will not build church for Mediterranean Sea. People could use like private jet for every members. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When he returned back, he started using those things to the glory of God. To him. But God was provoked against it. God was annoyed. Samuel now came. Why have you done this? Oh, I see those things now. I want you to sacrifice to God. Decorate the altar of God.
buy chair for pastor, do this, buy suit, keep members, everybody chop nyafu nyafu. God said, is God interested in your sacrifices? Is your sacrifice, is it accepted? Is obedience that God needs? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Is your obedience that can't? Not your sacrifices. Your sacrifices can be accepted if you are doing it in line with God, with what God said. Okay? So that we don't say, let me say, God not accept my sacrifice. He does. But on the right track. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's read Galatians chapter 3. I travel around the world. There is no one to trust. All my friends, they turn their backs at me. This is one thing I know. You are the only God I know. Jesus Christ, He never failed me yet. Galatians chapter 3. 26 to 28. If you are there, please read. 26 to 28.
Okay, it says, for ye are all the children of God by faith.
Yes.
In Christ Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
27. For as many of you as have been baptized into Christ has put on Christ. There is neither Jew or Greek. There is neither Jew nor of Greek. There is neither bond or free. There is neither man or female. For ye are all one in Christ Jesus. Shall we go down?
You've reached 28?
Yeah.
Okay. God bless you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah.
There is no boss, there is no master in the things of God. The only master we have is our Lord Jesus. We are all one in the face of God through Christ. There is neither Jew or Greek. There is no, I am from Igbo, I am from this. No partiality in Christ. When it comes to the things of God, it should be said and done in the way of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A man was sent to die for you and I, that by him we might have life and have it in abundance. How often do we remember about this man? When we are doing things, you know, if somebody is feeding you, for example, somebody is feeding you, pay on your bills, you will be conscious not to offend the person.
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
That is natural. When somebody is doing you good, somebody is taking care of you, doing some things in your life, you will see yourself trying to obey that person, trying not to make mistakes, trying to make sure that all you are doing pleases
him.
But when it comes to Baba God, then we don't care.
No.
That consciousness is not enough, and it ought not to be so. When we know the death and the resurrection of Jesus, what he meant to us, where he brought us from, where the price that he paid while we were yet slaves, how he brought us from darkness into his marvelous light, you and I will be conscious not to offend this man. It will help us to be careful if we know that we have gotten all things according to his riches in glory. We be conscious, but I don't know why we, human, okay? Why we find it difficult, or it's easier. We think we find it easier
to be conscious of men, trying to obey men, trying to do not offend man. But when it comes to God, it looks as if because he's not here, or because he don't see us, or because he doesn't take record, the soul that sinned shall die. Whatsoever a man sows, same shall he reap. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When you do something good, God will take care of you.
Amen.
There is this other scripture that we always quote. He's the God that killeth, the God that maketh alive.
Yes. Yes.
We have turned God to a killer. Most of us that are preachers or teachers or that carry the scripture, we don't know that preach the love of Christ. We only see God as he give and he take. As if he doesn't give without taking from you. We have preached this God to the extent that people are afraid. When I mean afraid, not the one of high esteem, not in the respect area, that even people are afraid to even embrace this God. If you see where people are preaching this God, he killeth, he maketh alive, he is the one that taketh and doeth this, he's the one that all the scriptures, we preach it to the extent that people don't longer see this God as a loving father. We don't longer see this God as a father that cares for his own. What else do you expect from a man, from God, who said, oh, my people have been taken into captive. The only way to redeem them, I have this, my son here. I cannot go and redeem them just this way. But I let me send him so that he should go and redeem my people back to me. When Adam sinned, man and God became enemies. But God was not happy with it. He never derived joy in things, seeing those things. In Ezekiel, he said, did God derive joy in the death of his people? He said, no. Not that they should repent and come to repentance. This is the God we are talking about. He's not happy to see anyone perish. That is why you and I sometimes, why God not go strike this person? Why God not do this? Why God not destroy this evil man? Why God not destroy this evil man? Even you could have been destroyed a long time ago. You could have destroyed a long time ago. But grace, his mercy, have kept each and every one of us. If God should mark iniquity, who will be able to stand? Who will be able to stand? Compare the Old Testament and the New Testament. You will see this God we are talking about. He doesn't derive pleasure. He's not happy to see you and I suffer. That was why Jesus proved it here. How can a man be blind? And you are telling me today is Sabbath.
Yes.
That I shouldn't heal him. That I shouldn't restore his life. That I shouldn't make him whole. A woman that was having horseback for good how many years?
Yes.
The teachers of the world were there.
Yes.
They see her every day. Yes. But they couldn't do anything. I think some people will be rejoicing.
Yes.
But a man came and healed him. Some people get offended. And they always find reason. They always find occasion to accuse him. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Christ is looking for every opportunity, every minute to save souls.
Amen.
That's why my daddy always said that we should look for every minute to assist somebody, no matter how little. That when he saw a scripture, and he said, trust in the Lord and do good.
Yes,
so that scripture transformed him.
Yes.
And our elder also echoed that when our daddy is here, he always looks for opportunity to help someone, no matter how little it is. Our Lord Jesus came to redeem us. He's not happy that you are in this situation.
No.
It's not that God that giveth and taketh the way we said it. In that natural. It's not that God that kills it. Our God is not a killer. Oh, our God is a jealous God now. If he's jealous, is he not jealous because of his own?
Yes, sir.
Did he come and jealous for your own?
No.
Hello?
Hi.
Yes, I've seen many arguments in that area. We say God, Jesus, God is not jealous God. But when you read the scripture, he only jealous of his own property. He's only jealous for things that belongs to him. Not to be jealous about another man. Not to be jealous about another brother or sister. If you want to be jealous of what belongs to you. The same thing our Lord God did. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Believers are not like uncircumcised. When you accept Jesus, when you come to know him, who is this Lord that I might? Even the man was even still walking with him, he never knew. Hello?
Yeah.
Because he asked, who is this Lord that I should believe on him now? He said, you are his me. He's me you are standing with. That means, even when he was still defending himself, he was not yet confident of who he was preaching.
No.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Understanding, I don't know him to that extent. The more I know him, the more I want to know him. I'm not okay in this situation. I need more of him. I make researches every day to go deeper and deeper and deeper. Don't just take one verse or two and just think you have known God. Because you carry a Bible, you think you are a Christian because you can quote. There are so many people that can quote scripture from Genesis to Revelation. But it doesn't function that way. It is those that do the will of the Father. Sunday school this morning also echoed more on it. When he was talking about a man will be known by his wisdom, his knowledge. If I look at you, how do I know if you have wisdom? Is it not your work?
Yes.
Your action?
Yes.
Your deed? How you behave? To know that you are a Christian is your work. It's your work that will prove. It comes to a time that every work will pass through fire. Through fire. Through fire. Some will die in that fire.
Exactly.
Some will cross. And those that cross will become gold.
Amen.
It's not easy. It's a process. And God does not want you and I to jump and enter. It's not a work like that. He requires us just to have this mindset and start working. It doesn't matter how long he takes. The most important thing, like Daddy used to say, though I never reached here, but I have departed.
Yes.
I'm not longer where I used to be. I have departed. In other words, I'm only on my way.
Yes.
On my way. Every day, working on it. Not to remain in one place. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In summary, for all that I have been saying, the death of Jesus of Nazareth can only make manifest in your life, in my life, if only we accept. If only we believe that we are blind. If only I believe that I don't know it and I want to know. In a class, when a student that think he knows his work, you know, when they are in class and not with this topic, you think you have known it all. Though some will be patient, following the teacher, learning, keep learning. Why there are some who think they have known it all? I remember in those days, in exam, you know, there are sometimes you will be carried away. I read one question, I go answer another thing. I read another question, answer another thing. You know, there are some calls after exam, you think you have done well.
Yes, sir.
When others go, they think, hey, I don't know whether I make it or. You now went, you go, they come across. Praise the Lord. I not been just 10 questions. I even borrow extra sheets. I borrow the extra sheets. Why others that wrote just a little will be thinking, how far have I done the right thing? What have I done? What did I wrote today? How am I sure I will pass this text? When results will come out, you will find out that you when they raise your shoulder, you will get F or D. Why others that wrote one, just one, they will even have good better results. They will have B or other, will have C. Praise the Lord. So it doesn't matter how far you think you have known it. Jesus is knocking at our door today. All he needs from us is humility. Just believe that with him is the one that can raise you. And if he is your Lord and your master, he should be the one in charge, determining for you.
Amen.
Whenever you want to take action, Father, do I pursue? That is why I love David. In all his sin, sometimes I will carry David's story, start to look for whose sin reached David. Whose sin reached David? I start comparing. I never see. We are not rich, or where God has opened my eyes, I have not seen. But this same man, God says, the man after my own heart. Why? Because of how he does it things. He killed Uriah, he married his wife. A rebuke come. David, you have done abominable things. He tried to entreat God. He prayed. God said, you lie. Protocol. No, you can't break it. This child will go. The child go. But David always acknowledged his faults. Always go on. He doesn't argue. He doesn't give reasons. I said, I'm that time with even our daddy, our papa. Go say, Elder, stop giving reasons why you do what. Because I always try to give reasons. And when you start giving reasons, Pastor Suleiman said, any man that always gives reasons for his anger will do more and do more. Because everything he will be doing, he will always see reasons.
Yes.
See the reason why. And everything has reasons. Even when you smash not begin, there is a reason. Anything you do, there is a reason. And when you start giving reasons, you won't learn. You will not make an amendment. So it takes someone, when correction comes, does that, oh, because I do am just to, like what Saul did, I carry those things now just to do this, just to please to God, just to sacrifice you. Who asks you? God not knows what you think I'm doing. He sees it already.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
So David will always portray himself. Anytime you... That you are a believer doesn't mean you will not sin, but you don't remain there. That you are a child of God, this is a sinful world. The world is a sinful place. If I try to avoid you, I cannot avoid you.
No.
Even when I try to avoid you, I will still jam another one.
Yes.
If you run from here, you go. Have you seen sometimes you take some certain decision?
Yes.
You see, like for example, sometimes, let me use this one. Sometimes some of us are used to borrow people money. When you need, you know they see who borrow you. It will come to a time, you say, today, I'm not good. From today, I swear, I can never borrow person money again. Before you swear, finish. God don't care.
God.
Why you are still swearing? God don't knock for you. It happens to me most occasions, eh? I'm not going to do it again. That's why you say you're not going to do it again. If they wait for you for the month, immediately you finish it, if they come to really prove whether you go do or you're not going to. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So please, whatsoever we find that we are doing that derives joy, that gives God joy, that pleases God, we should do it.
Amen.
We should always reflect ourselves. That's why I like this sister, though I don't know the calendar, whether it's correct. Hello? Yes, now go to YouTube these days, this period, now you will see different definitions, different messages, different explanations. They will tell you that celebration of Easter is for the world. So we say celebration of Easter is this. So we start giving reasons, they might be right, okay? But what I'm trying to say is that let us also have some times of sober reflection to also see the death and the resurrection of this God. Let souls also be transformed. Those when we don't work out far before, may they still draw. You know when you leave a dog, you don't work out, sometimes you still draw. Come back again.
Praise the Lord. This period, let us also preach the gospel, the good news, the death and the resurrection of Jesus. Not be happy Easter, happy Easter. Happy Easter, happy Easter. Tell people what the Easter, what they say the Easter stand for. The death and the resurrection of Jesus. Help us something into the mind of somebody. So that's shocking. You know, there are sometimes, if my wife, they do some certain things, if I never choke him, in consciousness, not will come back. Praise the Lord. It's happened even in children. Yes. Sometimes your children, they will think that you don't free them for the house. Exactly. They will like turn them upside down.
Yay.
But the time we come, you will choke them again. All of them will go into hiding.
Yes.
Look for a word. Look for a scripture. Look for a message in the Bible. Send it to somebody this period.
Yes.
Let the person have sober reflection.
Yes.
Let him also think. Let him know that there was one who had died for him or her.
Amen.
Not be happy Easter, because now with the same money they go to Nigeria now for Easter.
Amen.
Scripture will not go same. Telling them about the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So please, we, and why I'm saying this also, I'm also doing the same thing. I always preach what I'm guilty of, so that it can enable me to stand. If you look many men of God that God have used, I don't know whether I'm preaching or they preach, but will you understand what I'm saying? Because today they go another direction to the glory of God. If you look many men of God that God have used, God always pick them from somewhere, not already made.
No.
They must always have history.
Yes.
They must always have back.
Yes.
Because in that back they can stand, like what David said. When bears arise to come and fight, I destroy it.
Yes.
If you never get that experience, when they pray for somebody, he go run now. There was a day we were praying for somebody here. That is said it one day now. When I see face like python in this place, even me, I was at fear. To God who made me. And sometimes when that thing, when I remember that occasion, I can't go say I did it with pastor. If God said I will let me, maybe I will bag her. I will come back later. God will touch. No, I'm telling you, we were praying for somebody here. And all of a sudden, the face changed. When my first time to see such, face changed like python. I was terrified. If not, we said, I'm pastor, me, I'm daddy day here. I'm a run. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It's not easy.
It's not easy.
Now, it takes grace,
yes,
and God to train them,
yes,
in whichever way.
Yes.
Even some, there are some pastors who are sick,
yes,
come from sickness.
Yes.
If they are preaching to somebody on healing, they will know what they are saying.
Yes.
Pastor that goes through foundational issues,
yes,
when he's preaching about foundational matter, he will be coming with anointing, with boldness, because he knows where he's coming from.
Yes.
The one that doesn't go through that direction can't preach it that way.
No.
The one that suffers marriages. Oh, you be pastor, why you go divorce? Why you not go divorce? Do you think it's easy? Hello, it's issues of the world.
Yeah.
It can happen to anybody.
Yes,
he might be able to stand it. What about the other partner? Hello? Now, it's not the pastor that want to talk to you. He went on divorce. Wait till he get what he want to tell me. He have a lot to tell you.
Yeah.
He has gone through training.
Yeah.
He have made mistake.
Yeah.
That mistake, he can use it to build you, to edify you.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah!
So, it's good. We never despise anybody. All these messages are to the glory of God. God bless you.
Thank you.